With that said, I did wrestle a Texas Tornado in WWF for the Superstars of Wrestling.
Texas Tornado making his way down to a tremendous ovation.
Why would you want to touch
a fans here in Dayton for this youngster?
Why would you want to touch a bunch of dirty little kids?
What dirty little kids?
All he wanted was shaking hands out.
Will you be serious? Imagine having to go through life with that moniker, Bob Smedley.
I don't know if anyone can find it out there. If anyone can, probably text. But I wrestled. I did about six or eight TV spots for them back in the day. And I was in two cities back-to-back. I couldn't tell you if it's Fort Wayne, Indiana, or Toledo, Dayton, Ohio, or somewhere in that area. They contacted me. And one of the nights I got to work with Kerry. Really quick match, just like the Ric Flair one. Basically, we just done a few things. I called whatever. He was so easy to work with. I already knew the finish, which is going to be the discus punch is what it was called then. I honestly can't tell you like I could the Piper match, the details of it. But basically, I knew that's who I was working. 5 minutes before we go to bell time, you know, I'm standing in a gorilla position. The guys, Danny Davis, dangerous Danny Davis, the referee you was talking about in the past. They said, you got to go find Kerry. And I'm like, what? And it's one of those same stories. But, yeah, I find him. And I just walked up a hallway, and he was up there just, you know, kind of lacing his boot. And I said, you know, I think we're up. And he was real courteous, real professional, no big deal, not a big talker, nothing like that. We just walked out there, and he said, you know, have fun, whatever, and watch the discus punch. And I forgot how we set it up. Basically, I fed into it. I didn't feel anything. I went down one, two, three, and a thank you, and, you know, that's that. But I had always admired his body and stuff, but it was obviously a different carry that I was working than the one that, you know, was in his prime. You know what I'm saying? He was kind of on the way out physically and mentally at that point for a lot of other reasons, I guess, which is none of my business. I'm just saying it was an honor to get the wrestle one to Von Erich's, however brief it was. I did get to do that. And so I could always say that, you know, what the hell? It wasn't at the Sportatorium, but it's still Kerry Von Erich, you know? So.
Yeah.
All right.
I don't think they're concerned with thinking. They just want to go out there and start smashing.
Oh, there it is. The spinning Texas Tornado hooks the leg. Forget about it. He could put away any one of that foursome with that move right there. Youngster.
Now this is a great wrestling move. Hits the guy behind the head with a punch. Not a bad physique for a tornado.
Read the book that has the literary and wrestling worlds on fire. Pin Me, Pay Me, Have Boots Will Travel by accomplished professional wrestler Bobby Blaze Smedley. The incredible story of one man's battle to overcome all odds and realize a lifelong dream. Travel with Bobby in the ring, on the road, and around the world, including inside stories from WWE, WCW, Smoky Mountain Wrestling, and more. Forward to the book written by Jim Cornette.